If you're looking to create a professional website for your business, an event you're hosting, your blog, a personal page, or simply to use as a platform to showcase your work and talent, then you might want to try out Wix, an extremely powerful website creation platform that allows you to create tremendously customizable and professional-looking websites in a relatively short amount of time. Well, in this video, I'm going to be showing you step-by-step how to go from a completely blank slate to a professional website you would think belongs to a Fortune 500 company. Now, this is going to be a fairly in-depth video, so I'm going to leave timestamps in the description in case you want to skip to a specific point in the video. And one last thing, this video is sponsored by Wix. Although, to be honest, I've known about Wix for quite a while now, and I've always held it in high regard, so rest assured, everything you'll be hearing in this video is my actual opinion. And by the way, I upgraded my microphone. What do you guys think? I think it sounds very crisp. And with that out of the way, let's get right into the tutorial. Alright, so first things first, you're going to want to click the first link in the description, so that we're on the same page, and it should take you right here. Alright, then you're going to want to click on Start Now. Then either sign up or log in, depending on if you have a pre-existing account or not. I already created my account, so I'm going to log in here. But don't worry, the process should be fairly similar. Alright, so after you've signed up or logged in, you should be looking at a page similar to this one. If it's not exactly the same, don't worry, the process should be fairly similar. First, click on Let's Do It, and then Wix is going to ask you some questions about what kind of a website you are going to be building. So after you finish answering these questions, you're going to be looking at a page similar to this. Now here, you're going to want to choose between Wix's ADI or the editor. So basically, the ADI will ask you some questions, and then it will generate a website depending on the answers. But in my opinion, it's probably a better idea to use the editor, since you lose a lot of the customizability when using the ADI. So for this tutorial, I am going to be using the editor, and I also recommend you use the editor as well. So after selecting the Wix editor, you will be presented with several different website templates with which you can start building your website. Keep in mind that your final product most likely won't look anything similar to these templates. However, they are a good starting ground for if you are new to building websites. Alright, so I think I'm going to go with this template right here. I just think it would fit really well with the idea I have for my website. First, click on View Demo to get an idea of how the website will look in a real setting. After you've found the template you want to use, click on it and you will enter the Wix editor. Now this is where the real magic happens. So real quick, I just want to explain the basics of the editor. So on the right, you can see a box with lots of tools in it, which can reposition, resize, rotate, delete, and duplicate different elements you have on your website. On the top right hand corner, you can see a save button, which you should regularly press as to not lose any progress. A preview button is also on the top right, with which you can preview your website outside of the editor. On the top left hand corner, you can switch from the desktop view to the mobile view to see how your website holds up on a mobile device. You can also edit your websites separately on these two settings. On the left, you can see several different menus, which we will get to in a moment. As for the actual website building, the main way to add more content is to add strips, which separate content on your page. You can also add separate pages other than your homepage, which you can link to with buttons located on your page. Now, regarding the menus on the left. So, all the way in the top, we have the Menu tab. In the Menu tab, you can mainly add different pages to your website, but you can also add in login info, booking pages, blog pages, member pages, and much more. So right underneath the Menu tab, you have a tab in which you can change the page's background. To do this, you can either upload images from your own library or choose from existing images in Wix's system. You can edit these images with an inbuilt image editor, and you can also add different scroll effects such as parallax, which is my personal favorite. Right underneath that, we have the Add tab. In the Add tab, you can add different elements such as images, text, videos, buttons, lists, social links, literally anything you can think of, you can add these into your website in this tab. Right after that, we have the Theme tab, in which you can choose different color schemes for your website. Right after that, we have the Wix App Market, in which you can find apps to integrate into your website, such as Printful if you are setting up an online shop, for instance. Following that, we have the Media tab, in which you can import videos and images from your computer, or even social platforms such as YouTube or Instagram or Twitter, and use these in your website. And the last two tabs are a little bit more obscure. The second to last tab is a Blog tab, in which you can start your own blog, which is very easy to update in real time and also add more content to. And the last tab is the Ascend tab, which contains marketing tools you can use to promote your website. Now that I've explained the extensive list of features that Wix offers as a website creation platform, I am going to start with the creation of my very own website. So first things first, I'm going to remove all of the content I don't really need on the website. To delete items off of your page, simply select them and hit the delete key, like you would in any other program. After deleting most of the pre-existing content on my website, I'm going to import my YouTube channel logo by going to the Media tab. To do this, simply go to Add, then click on Image, and then click on My Image Uploads. Here, you can either drag in your image, or you can click on Upload Media, and search through your folders to find it directly. I'm also going to add some text from the Add tab. Once again, go to Add, then click on Text, and then choose your desired font. And I'm going to start to rearrange them until they fit my idea of what I want my website to look like. After some time, I settled on this formation right here. And I also think I'm going to add in a black bar, which you can select in the Add tab and then simply drag in. And I think this looks pretty good. Next, I want to experiment with some background images for my site, and I'm finding that a lot of the images just have way too much going on, and they won't really fit with my website. Now, I found this marble texture in Wix's library of images, which you can find by simply going to Page Background, and I'm going to slightly blur it in the image editor, and it just turned out amazing. All you have to do to get to the image editor is go to your page background, and then click on the button right next to Settings. Now, I think I want to add an About Me section, so I'm going to click on the Add tab, and then I'm going to add a strip using this template, and I'm going to switch out the image with one of my own creations. To do this, simply select the template image, click on Change Column Background, and then click on Image, and from there you can add in your own image, or choose an image from Wix's library. If anyone wants to see a tutorial on how to make this image, by the way, just let me know in the comments. From there, I simply changed the font of the text, which you can do by selecting it, and then changing it from inside the editor, altered the arrangement slightly, and then added an About Me title by simply going to Add and then clicking on Text. And last but not least, I changed the column background to white. Alright, so now I've finished the About Me section of my website, and now I'm going to go on to edit the contact strip on the bottom of my page. Alright, so I'm not going to do much here, I'm just going to change up the design somewhat. I also want to add my social links, and by social links I actually mean social link, since it's just my YouTube channel at the moment. But all you have to do is go to Add, then click on Social, add the social icons you want, and then connect a link to them. It's as simple as that. Alright, so I figure it would be a really cool idea to embed some of my videos onto this website. This is also very simple to do. Just go to Add, then click on Videos and Music, and then click on YouTube if you want to embed a YouTube video, although you could also use other social media sites or simply upload the file directly. Finally, I'm going to add in some anchors. These allow me to add in buttons on the top of my page, which you can click on and it will send you directly to the corresponding section of my page. So what you're going to want to do is go to Add, then click on Menu, and then click on Anchor. Once you have an anchor on your page, you can move it around as much as you like. Then rename it to something you can remember, because we're going to link it to a button in a second here. Once you have all your anchor points set up, click on Add and then click on Button, And then once you have your button on your page, you're gonna link it up to the anchor point like so. Then when your website is live, when you click on the button, it will scroll down to the selected anchor point. Alright, so after rearranging some aspects of the page, I think I'm happy with it. Now, it's time to publish the page. Obviously, having a website up and running can't be free, so Wix offers several different payment packages which you can select depending on your situation. So you can choose between a personal website and a business website. I would only suggest going with the business website if you have some kind of payment processing built into your website. Otherwise, I'd go with the personal option, especially if you're just doing a personal project or if you're building a personal portfolio. As for the price ranges, if you're just starting out and you just want to get a feel for the website creation process, I'd suggest choosing a package on the lower end of the price spectrum. If you are already experienced and you know that you need a big website for a larger corporation, or if you just need to upload lots of files with a very large file size, then I'd suggest going with a more expensive package. But it really just depends on what kind of a website you want to build, and it also very much depends on your financial situation. So once you have your payment plan, click on publish. Now your website is up and running, but you still don't have a custom domain. So what you're going to want to do is go to your dashboard, and you should see an option to connect a domain. You can either connect an existing domain or purchase one through Wix directly, which is exactly what I did since it's way more convenient. FrozenFractal.com was sadly taken, but the Frozen Fractal was not, so I went with that option. So once you have your custom domain, the last step is to edit your SEO, or search engine optimization. Click on Get Started in your dashboard to, well, get started. First, you need to enter your business or site name. Then select if you have a physical location or not, and finally describe your business in up to 3 keyword phrases. Once you're done, click on Create SEO Plan, and Wix will generate a SEO plan for your website based on your answers. Wix is basically making sure here that your website is seen by as many people as possible. They're going to edit the tags, the titles, the descriptions, and make sure that everything is absolutely optimized and you get the most amount of exposure that you can. I see that 2 options are still not checked off, so I'll quickly go back to the editor and add a homepage title and a description to increase my search engine optimization. Alright, so after publishing my website for the final time and taking a look at it, I think I did a pretty good job overall. It looks very sleek and very professional, and it only took me around 2 hours to complete the whole thing, which is honestly insane. And that brings us to the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it and learned something new. Once again, if you want to try creating your own website, click the first link in the description to get started. If you enjoyed the video and want to see more content just like this, consider subscribing. It's completely free and you can unsubscribe at any time. But for now guys, stay safe, have a great rest of your day, and I will see you in the next one. See ya!